This tutorial will show you how to use the built-in logic analyzer in Keil. We can view up to 4 variables graphically in the logic analyzer. These variables must be global, static, or raw addresses. This is STM32F4 Discovery Kit. It has an onboard SD link debugger and L4 ARM Cortex-M4F microcontroller. Let's see how these two components communicate with each other. ARM Cortex-M microcontroller uses ARM core-side debug module. The core-side module provides powerful debug and trace capabilities. It has two interfaces, the debug interface and the trace interface. The debug interface can be used to start and stop a program, execute one line of source code, set hardware breakpoints, read and write memory and peripheral registers on the fly. The trace interface provides program counter sampling and data trace and event trace information. The trace interface does not steal any CPU cycles and it's completely non-intrusive, except for printf. A serial wire debugger gives the host PC full access to the core-side debug module. The debugger connects the debug interface via two wires, serial wire data inputs output, and serial wire clock. The debugger connects to the trace interface via a single wire, serial wire output. SD link is a serial wire debugger. The SD link debugger is connected to the STM32L4 microcontroller via pin PA13, PA14, and PB3. If software mistakenly changes the mode or alternate function of these pins, the debugger will fail to program or debug the microcontroller. Unfortunately, the SWO pin of the microcontroller is not connected to the ST link on the board. The SWO pin, PB3, is connected to TSWO via the solder bridge 14, which is disconnected by default. Therefore, we need to do a little soldering work to connect two soldering pads of solder bridge 14. Here is what SB14 looks like after we soldered it. Now, let's demo how to use the logic analyzer in Keil. This is a simple program. After setting up SysDig and GPIO, the main program repeatedly toggles the red LED every second. The delay function is implemented by using SysDig interrupts. To use the logic analyzer, we need to enable tracing in the debug setting first. Click the icon, options for the target, select the debug page, make sure STLink debugger is selected, click settings, go to the trace page, enter the call clock frequency. Make sure that this frequency matches the processor call frequency set by your software. The debugger uses this software to calculate timings for trace capturing and displaying. Since my software sets Cortex-M4 call to run at 8 MHz, I put 8 MHz here. Next, select Trace Enable to capture traces via the SWO pin. Click OK to save and exit the debug configuration. Next, we'll configure Logical Analyzer. The logical analyzer can only be configured in the debug process. Click the debug icon to start debug. Go to the menu, view, analysis window, select logical analyzer, click the button setup. We can view up to 4 variables graphically in the logical analyzer. These variables must be global, static, or raw addresses. First, let's get a trace of a global variable defined in my C program. This global variable is called msticks. Click new, type msticks, hit enter, highlight this variable, change the maximum value to 1000 because that's the maximum value it can be. Click close, click run. I have shown you how to trace a global variable. We can also trace the data stored at a raw address. Suppose we want to trace the output on the red LED, which is connected to GPIO pin PB2. Let's pause the simulation. Click Setup. Click New. Let's add this impression. The numerical value is the memory address of the output data register, ODR, of GPIO port B. Enter. And let's select bit. Since we are only interested in bit 2 of the ODR register, we want to set up the mask and the shift operands. Close. For comparison, we add another one. New GPIO B ODR. Enter. Highlight this. Change to bit. Set up the mask. Shift right by 2-bit. Click OK. Let's restart the simulation. Click 1. Let's pause the simulation. Now we can measure the time span between different data points. So see, the time span is approximately 1 second. Thank you for watching. Please visit the book website for more information and tutorials.